on a hill called Calvary. He mounted up a cross, a beam, and they mocked him. They made fun of him. They spat upon him, but he continued to carry the cross. When he was weak in himself, even Simon jumped in and helped him carry it. But at the end of the day, it was his cross to bear. The sins of humanity hung on that cross. Our sins, our shame, our guilt was hung on that cross. The Son of the Living God hung that day on that Good Friday. The blood ran down. He gave up his last breath on that cross. The earth trembled, the heavens rolled, graves opened, as God alone watched his only begotten Son die. But I want to tell you, that's not the end of the story. They laid him in the borrowed tomb of Joseph of Arimathea. They laid his body as it was wrapped in grave clothes. But on that Sunday morning, when they came to bring spices to the dead body of Jesus, they found out that the stone was rolled away. They found out that he wasn't there no more, that God had sent a messenger. God had put his angels there to let them know that the one they sought after was not here. Why do you seek the living among the dead? On that day, we celebrate Resurrection Day. The day that he got up, the day that our Lord and Savior conquered death, hell, and the grave. And today that same resurrection lives inside of every believer. Those who have confessed Jesus Christ to be Lord and Savior of their life, but most importantly, who get up with him every day, who have taken on the mind of Jesus, who have clothed themselves with his glorious righteousness, and to know that he still lives. He's alive forevermore. Death could not hold him. The grave could not bind him. And today he is seated at the right hand of the Father. He has sent the Holy Spirit, and today he is alive inside of us. There is good news today. Good news for every person who is lost. Good news for every person who is bound. Good news for every person that is addicted to drugs. Good news to every person that is struggling in a wayward life today. And that good news is that he is alive to save you. He is alive to deliver you. He is alive to bring you out of that dead state and continue to bring you into a life that he said that we could live in abundance. That life of joy, that life of peace, that life of hope that he has paid the price for so that we can live and not die. And I'm so grateful today to know that he still lives, that my Redeemer lives, that I can get up and face tomorrow, that I have a hope in him and my future is sealed in him, and I am saved by his marvelous grace. And you today have that same opportunity. Get a hold of it, reach out and grab it. Grab a hold of Jesus, touch that hem of his garment, and receive all that he has for you.